This is Mark Bell from Supertraining.tv, Supertraining Gym, the strongest gym in the West. Got a lot of questions to go through. I'm trying to go through multiple questions within one video, so here we go. We got a guy asking about his neck injuries. What can you do to strengthen the neck? What can you do for your neck? And that kind of stuff. Realize this, everyone out there, anyone who exercises, anyone who does a sport, understand that you have a greater opportunity of hurting yourself pretty much 24 hours a day outside of the gym than you do inside the gym. Especially those of you that are experienced with lifting. Somebody like myself gets underneath the squat, gets underneath the bench, gets set up for a deadlift, and I know how to do those lifts. I've been doing them for years. Odds of me hurting myself are slim to none. Unless I'm trying something new, or unless there's a new stimulus, more weight, more reps, more sets, whatever. Odds of me hurting myself on that lift, the lift is going to last a maximum of, even if I do some reps, it's going to last a maximum of about 20 seconds or so. And I'm going to get my body tight and coiled up and really ready to go. And more than likely, I will not get hurt. However, when you're sitting around and you're texting like this, and you're doing all that kind of stupid shit all day long, and you're sitting in your chair all humped over, and you're driving all messed up, sitting is one of the worst things that can possibly be done. So, Mr. Neck Injury here, Jim Mitchell, make sure that you are practicing good technique everywhere you go, keeping your back neutral, keeping your stomach mildly tight. Your stomach should always be turned on by about 20% as if you're ready for a punch. Things to do for your neck, try to make sure that you have good posture is number one. Number two is to do some exercises for your neck. I would start out real easy. Maybe just grab a band, put it behind your head, and just do some extension work. You can do some work where you're pushing against it as well. You can do some side-to-side work. Even just using the weight of your own head. My head weighs 47 pounds, so that would be pretty heavy. But using the weight of your own head would be good. A good start. You can do things like kind of bridges up against the wall, where you just kind of lean out from the wall and just push the back of your head into the wall. Exercises like that are good for strengthening your neck. If it feels, our good friend Kelly Starrett says, if it feels sketchy, it is sketchy. So if you do something and you feel a lot of pain in your neck, then fucking stop doing it. Okay, on to the next one. We got Jazz Singh, I guess his name is. He asked, you know, what do you do when you're recovering from a flu? What do you do when you're recovering from being sick? Do you come back in at like 40%, 50%? What if you had something scheduled for the day that's supposed to be really freaking hard? Well, you know, use your head. Again, if it's sketchy, it's sketchy. If it's shady, it's shady. If it sounds like it's going to hurt, it probably will. So, you know, use your noggin. Use your head. If you feel like shit, odds are you're probably going to lift like shit. Some of us can pull it out of our ass every once in a while and still have a good day, but that's not the norm. If you're banged up, you're banged up. If you can't go in there and perform at 100%, you really don't belong in there. You're not going to make the gains you're looking for anyway. Mentally, from a mental aspect, we do have to be in there, right? We do have to keep training. We do have to keep pushing on. For the old brain, which is one of the most powerful things that we got. So for myself, when I'm sick, when I'm recovering from something, I try to just be a little bit more realistic about my training. I don't really set anything up to be backed off or anything, because I don't like backing off or backing down from anything. I like to just kind of keep pushing forward. If I'm really that sick, I just don't go to the gym because I don't want to get everybody else sick. So there's been days where I just completely miss 100%, just don't even go in at all. And I don't try to make up those days. I think that's a mistake, too. Just skip it all together and get back on track, with your next workout. Hopefully that answers your question. We'll go on to the next one. Try not to make this run too long. Let's see. This guy says he has a problem activating his triceps when he's doing a bench press. Well, whenever you're lifting heavy, you're not going to really get like a pump like you normally would if you were doing, you know, bodybuilding style stuff, doing a close grip bench press, partial range of motion, the way you would see someone like Jay Cutler or something do. Then obviously it's going to feel a lot different than if you're handling maximal weights. So in order to activate your triceps, you probably just need to use less weight, and you need to flex your triceps through the movement, and you need to press them hard through the movement. That'll help you feel your triceps. That would be more like an assistance exercise. You do your main exercise first, the main event, get that shit out the way, and then you move on to something else afterwards where you're going to be using lighter weight, but you're going to have more control, and you're going to be after the hypertrophy, muscular hypertrophy. That's the ultimate trophy to win, by the way. And let's go on to the next one. Let's see what we got here. Could you post how to build a bigger squat, how to build a bigger deadlift video? I know the keys are form, blah, blah, blah. In short, I could say, you know, how you're going to build a bigger squat. You really got to read up on the West Side Book of Methods from Louis Simmons, and that'll help your squat and your deadlift more so than anything. Subscribe to Power Magazine. Keep watching these videos. Building a bigger squat and a bigger deadlift. What builds a bigger squat and a bigger deadlift at the same time? I hear someone say it. Did you say it? Fat little fucker in the corner over there, did you say it? I heard someone say it. Box squats. Box squats done properly can help your squat and your deadlift, as well as pause squats. They can help your squat and your deadlift, although those are demoralizing and humiliating because you have to use such a light weight. But a box squat, learning how to box squat, watch supertraining.tv, watch some of our videos, watch some of the stuff coming out of Westside Barbell. It's westsidebarbell.com. Order some videos from Louis Simmons and watch that shit. I'm not sponsored by Louis, but Louis's the man. He's the source of information. And that's it from supertraining.tv.